Hello, my name is Raj Pochiraju, and I'm a Principal Program Manager in Azure SQL Group at Microsoft. And I manage the Arc-enabled SQL servers that help you to manage secure your SQL Server estate from a single control plane Azure. And today I'm going to talk about how Arc really help you to take the business transformation journey. We are in the brink of new age, where it is increasingly crucial for companies like you to become agile and AI ready. To achieve these goals in an on-premises environment, it is very difficult with the distributed systems. App latency is the big thing. And this is something that we hear from our customers, that having applications and then the APIs located in different data centers, different regions, oftentimes leads to suboptimal performance and then less agility to scale that your business really required. The same thing applies to the database systems as well. And huge volumes of data sets are a critical part of the AI. And it is very important for us to avoid the disparate data sets and data silos. And to build this high-performing infrastructure in an on-premises environment is very expensive. And especially with the rapid changes and evaluations that are coming in infrastructure and as well as the processor worlds. Now let's take a look at how migrating to Azure really help you to become more agile and AI ready. The co-location is the key aspect. Azure offers co-location to you for your applications. When your applications co-located along with your APIs and as well as the databases, it leads to 2% faster GPU throughput. And then co-locating your services also gives you a flexibility that you can really integrate the services such as Azure Copilot as well as AI services seamlessly into your workloads. And there is a recent Forrester survey which really suggests that a 150% increase in productivity when workload starts using the AI services. And then Microsoft also offers, make sure that it ensures to practice the secure, safe, and responsible AI practices. And we really never tune our models with the user data. And then Microsoft completed 100 plus certifications, which is most in the industry. The process of cloud migration journey has multiple steps, starting from discovery, planning, execution, and then optimization. Microsoft has built some robust services like Azure Migrate that really help you to take that migration journey. But migration is not something one size fits all solution. Each organizational unit has a different set of migration journey requirements. And depending on the complexity and size of the migration, these migrations can take months to sometimes even years. And as a DBA, you find yourself managing SQL servers that are deployed in multiple environments. SQL servers on the on-premises, SQL servers on the hybrid environment, and multi-cloud. It is very challenging for you to drive that business transformation, but at the same time to achieve the short-term goals. It's really a balancing act. And Microsoft really helps you to achieve that balancing act through SQL servers enabled in Azure Arc. Now let's see how Azure Arc really help you to go through the business transformation. Azure provides three major capabilities. It helps you to manage, secure, and protect your SQL servers from the single control plane in Azure, regardless where these SQL servers are deployed, on-premises, in multi-cloud environment. At the same time, Azure Arc also enables you to perform a streamlined migration experience as well. So at first, manage. Arc really helps you to have a single viewpoint of all your SQL servers across your estate in a single control plane in Azure. With Microsoft SQL Server best practice assessment, you can be able to run your SQL Server environment in a healthy state. With the business continuity capabilities, you can really automate all the backups for your SQL servers from Azure. You can also have a single view of your availability groups and failover cluster instances across your entire SQL Server estate in the Azure, and you can be able to go and then manage those environments as well. And then with the Microsoft Defender integrated with Azure Arc, you can safeguard your SQL Server so that you can really protect your SQL Server from the vulnerabilities and as well as the brute force attacks. And with Purview, you can govern and manage the access control for the SQL Server using the Purview policies without even writing a single T-SQL statement to achieve this. And finally, Azure Arc really helps you to seamlessly migrate your environments to the Azure. Now, in summary, our message to you is that we want you to embark your cloud migration journey using Azure Arc. So on the day one itself, it is going to help you to optimize your operations, and it also provides you a seamless migration experience. Now, let me introduce you our newest feature, SQL Server Migration Assessment, enabled in SQL Servers, enabled in Azure Arc. These assessments are auto-enabled for you. You don't have to do any additional configuration to get these assessments. And these assessments will really give you the readiness score, how ready your SQL Server environments migrating to Azure SQL Server deployment options, and also provides you the best fit recommendations that you can migrate that really optimizes your performance and cost. And like I said, these assessments are auto-enabled for you without any additional configuration. And then these assessments are supported from SQL Server 2012 and above. Now, let me introduce you the new SQL Server Migration Assessment that we released with SQL Servers enabled by Azure Arc. So you are seeing an Arc-enabled SQL Server instance on my screen now, and it already telling you that the migration assessment is ready, and then it's pointing you to review that migration assessment. So let me do that. And I go to this migration assessment, and what it does is that it provides you the readiness score across the three deployment options that we have: Azure SQL Managed Instance, Azure SQL Server Database, and as well as a SQL Server which is running on Azure VM. It really gives you how ready your SQL Server workloads migrating to any of these deployment options so that you can really migrate to a deployment option of your choice. If you want to migrate to a fully managed service, your preference would be Azure SQL MI, Managed Instance in the Azure. Or if you want to really control the operating system and as well as some of those functionalities of your SQL Server, then you will be migrating to a SQL Server which is running on the VM. In all these cases, not only that it is going to give you the readiness of your SQL Server environment, it also gives you a report if there are any migration blockers for any particular deployment option and provide you the mitigation steps. So in this example with Azure SQL Database, it shows that your SQL Server databases are not ready to migrate to Azure SQL Database. And then let's examine why the assessment says it is not ready. So for the SQL Server databases, there are few databases that have the migration issues. For example, this particular database is using, or this workload is using, a service broker feature which is not supported on the Azure SQL Database. But whereas if you go to SQL MI, you don't really see that issue because the service broker is natively supported in the SQL Server MI. So that way you really understand which of these deployment options that you have some migration issues that you need to resolve, or the other deployment options where you don't have to really resolve any migration issues, and then you can really migrate with zero effort. So that's how these assessments really help you to migrate to Azure SQL. And then for any of these deployment options that the assessment shows ready to migrate, then it also gives you the best fit recommendation for each of these deployment options, which we call that as a SKU recommendation. That SKU recommendation includes the specific deployment option, the tier that you can really migrate to, and the size of your deployment option in terms of the vCore and as well as the storage. And we make this recommendation based on the performance data that we continuously collect for the last 30 days. And we collect these performance data to measure your CPU performance, your memory requirements for your workload, and disk IO apps, response times, IO response times. So we look into all these performance metrics, and we continuously collect for the last 30 days. And we collect those performance points every 30 seconds, aggregate them for every 10 minutes, and upload to the cloud so that the assessment will process those results and then really come up with particular SKU recommendation that can really meet your performance requirements. And given that we are assessing this data for last 30 days, it will really accommodate all type of workloads, whether it can be a day-to-day online transactions, or it could be some sort of the batch jobs that run during the weekly basis, or it can be even monthly end reports. So we accommodate all types of workloads that comes into your SQL Server application, and based on that, we really make a recommendation that really best fit your target Azure SQL deployment to really optimize your performance and cost. So that way you can really use this assessment report to really plan your SQL Server workload migrations. And when you are really ready to migrate, we also provide the guidance how you can really use different tools to migrate. In this case, we kind of recommend use our Azure Database Migration Service to migrate your SQL Server workload to SQL Server Manager instance in this case. In the future, we are going to be automating your migration experience as well to provide a zero downtime migration experience through Arc. So that way you will really find out the end-to-end migration experience within the Arc SQL Server. That's the vision that we have at Microsoft to streamline your entire migration experience. So enjoy this assessment that we enabled and really plan your migrations. Like I said, these assessments are auto-enabled for you and continuously runs on a weekly basis and then provide you the recommendations, up-to-date recommendations for your source environments migrating to Azure SQL. And you don't have to do any additional configurations. All you need to do is just Arc enable your SQL servers. You will start getting these assessment reports to you. Now that you saw the assessment and you are comfortable to migrate to Azure, the next step is how do you really migrate by minimizing the impact to your business? And in the future, pretty soon, we are planning to enable near zero downtime migration experience to Azure SQL MI and SQL servers which are running on the VM. This migration is going to be an end-to-end migration, fully automated, including the provisioning of your Azure SQL deployment based on the assessment recommendations, and then continuously replicate the data. And when you are really ready to migrate, you complete your migration with a simple failover operation. And during the migration journey, you can be able to test your read-only workloads. And in case, if the migration is not successful, you can always roll back to the on-premises environment through this process. And this is coming pretty soon. After you migrate to Azure SQL, then this is the time that you really want to start leveraging the power of AI integration naturally happens into Azure SQL deployment options. With our Copilot integrated with Azure SQL, it really helps your developer experiences, and as well as it is going to help you for the all type of deployment operations. And then it also helps you to write very quickly the T-SQL statements that really solve the problems that you try to address for your business with a simple natural language. Now, I want to conclude by leaving some resources to you that really help you to learn more about Azure SQL, SQL servers enabled by Azure Arc, and the migration journey. We also have some case studies that you can understand how other customers really took that migration journey so that you can also follow some of those guidance. And thank you very much for your time, and I will talk to you soon.